from BBC Radio 4. Nuremberg. The trial of the Nazi war criminals. Drawn from eyewitness testimony, documents, and court transcripts, which uncover the distressing truth behind the Nazi atrocities. It's May 1945, and Germany has just surrendered. The country is in chaos. 1 million former soldiers, 3 million foreign nationals, another 1 million liberated from the concentration camps, all trying to get home. And hiding somewhere in all that, hoping to slip away, are the top Nazis. Episode 1. The Hunt.
Watch it, you lummox! Take it gently!
Sir, I just spent 8 years in the removals business.
Any satisfied customers?
Some of those lonely wives out in Connecticut, Sarge. I'm telling you.
Get it shifted, soldier. These are priceless antiques.
Was it because we took such a hammering in the Ardennes? Was it because half of us were Italians? Or was it just a regular usual snafu? But here we were, 391st Anti-Aircraft Battalion, battle-hardened, combat-ready, moving furniture and curtains and fancy brocades and I don't know what around the Grand Hotel Mondorf Spa in Luxembourg, which is like this special miniature country in the middle of Europe.
Hey, Sarge, come look at this.
Pretty place, don't get me wrong. You got the Mosel River just up there, and the opposite bank, that's France. Vineyards that way, thermal springs down there. It's good for the liver, they say.
Is this, real gold, Sarge?
You touch it, soldier. We got a flood on our hands.
2 weeks after VE Day, they sent us here, told us to get the place ready, the whole 8-story hotel, get it ready for a load of prisoners. And I mean top brass prisoners.
I want everything out of here. Move it.
And then into each room, one camp bed, one straw mattress.
Did I say bring a pillow? Did I, Garofalo? No pillows. One chair, one table, one wash basin.
People used to pay big bucks in this place. But this wasn't going to be no holiday. Now it's Continental Central Prisoner of War Enclosure 32. We gave it a code name. Ashcan.
Hey, Sarge, where do you want this? Whatever it is.
Meanwhile, our guys are out there all over Europe looking for him. Looking for Himmler and Goebbels and Goering and Ribbentrop and Bormann, maybe even Adolf himself. Maybe that suicide story's just BS. Maybe the Fuhrer's still out there, getting ready to crank it up again. The intelligence guys hunting them down, where do they start? All they have is the official residence or the barracks or last known address. They turn up and... zilch. Nada. Nicked. That's when there was still a house or a street.
Excuse me. Hey, Ed Schuldigung, this is Hindenburg Straße?
Yes. Straße Hindenburg, yes.
It was Hindenburg Street.
Don't think anyone lives here anymore.
Yeah, we've been bombing the guts out of Germany for months. Hamburg, Nuremberg, Leipzig, Munich. So they're all just brick heaps.
Please.
Bitte, please.
Cigarette.
Please.
Cigarette.
Chocolate.
Please. I mean, you walk around, you see smoke coming out of the ground. That's people living in cellars. and they're the lucky ones. You stub out your cigarette. 20 guys fight for what's left. In this sector alone, they reckon, we got 1 million wounded German citizens, 1.5 million prisoners of war, another 1 million foreign workers shipped into slave for the Reich. Except now the fields are empty and the houses are gone and the factories are blitzed. So it's the roads, just one long stream of people moving both directions, walking, walking, walking. Where are they all going? Most don't have homes to go back to. No trains, no trams, not a whole lot of cars. Got no telephones, no newspapers, no banks. So everywhere, it's people walking along the roads. And somewhere in the middle of all this are the criminals we're after. You know, one thing's for sure. Not one of them wants to get lifted by the Ruskies. They're all heading west into our sector. The French sector, or the British sector.
Please, please, von Ribbentrop. You come?
Hold on.
My father, yes?
Did you say Ribbentrop?
Okay. Von Ribbentrop.
He's on our list, isn't he?
Number 4 on the list. He's a big one.
This boy walks into British field security in Hamburg.
Your father is von Ribbentrop?
His father was some guy with a wine shop, friend of Ribbentrop back when he was a champagne salesman. That's before he marries, gets himself a von, and ends up Hitler's foreign minister. Go figure.
Sergeant, you're coming with me. Get 2 more. Sten guns, 2 magazines per man.
Turns out Reichsminister Ribbentrop, he's gone scurrying to an old buddy in Hamburg. Except Buddy was too scared to have him in his own house. Everyone knows these guys are Europe's most wanted. He sends von Rib to a woman in the suburbs, an attractive brunette with a rooming house.
Open up!
Yeah? Yes?
Fräulein Schuldigen, in you lot! Move it, search every room! Excuse us. Maybe you want to put a few more clothes on?
Do you have chocolate? Cigaretten?
Someone overhears the wine merchant talking about it. Tries to blackmail him. The son takes matters into his own hands.
Sir! Sir Rupina, got it!
He's sitting up in bed, typewriter on his lap, in pink and white pajamas.
You think this is him? This chap's rather older.
Gentlemen. The game is up. I congratulate you. You know exactly who I am.
Get on with it then. Full body search, quick!
Sir?
He had this tin taped to his leg.
What is this?
I have a letter here. Most important for Vincent Churchill. The Führer instructed me to deliver it personally. It is most urgent. Take me to Montgomery.
It's been hiding there for 6 weeks. So maybe it wasn't such an urgent mission.
And it's Winston. Winston Churchill.
Welcome to Ashcan, Mr. Ribbentrop.
Herr von Ribbentrop.
Uh-huh. Now on, you're a prisoner of 31G35002.
I have the Führer's personal instructions. We must come together to fight the Bolsheviks.
Hennessy, take this prisoner to room 48. Remove wristwatch, belt, shoelaces, suspenders, necktie.
He's wearing pajamas, sir.
So get the man some fatigues. Class X. Move it, soldier.
And that tin taped to his leg? Potassium cyanide. They were all given it. These big Nazis are shooting themselves, hanging themselves, poisoning themselves all over Germany. It's our job to get there first. Sometimes you can't. Himmler they had under arrest. They just didn't know.
You know who I am?
Just a small man with glasses, a bookkeeper in an army shirt and underpants.
I am Heinrich Himmler, Minister of the Interior. I commanded the SS.
They set about stripping him. The doctor comes in, searches between his toes, underarm.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.